I'm very pleased to be invited here. And I thought before I came here, I thought maybe this time I would have different faces. And eventually I come and I realized that many people here again, you know, and the same faces. I don't know. Anyway, so. And you know, I think a few months ago, I was here with my friend, Stephanie Greenface. So we both actually had a paper, which Mariana, I mentioned to you yesterday, the paper, which the paper, I couldn't remember the name of the paper, called AIIB, What AIIB Can Learn and Perhaps Can Teach Existing Development Institution, something like this paper. So if you're interested in the paper, you could download from the IDS website. So we both here was, we were here to meet Mr. Zhu Xian and NDB. And Stephanie said, look, Xiaoyun, this is my first time in Shanghai. And I heard about that the Shanghai has been changed over last 20 years or even 10 to 15 years. This is what she asked me. I said, as far as I remember, that this change really, really happens, you know, over last 2 decades even. And she said, well, and if your country can bring such a change, who else can teach you for the future? I said, well, this is a good question. And many people have been keeping telling us. Many people, perhaps like US, sorry, I'm just joking. And this conversation reminded me for the topic, my topic. I didn't really prepare any PPP. So I'd like to use this opportunity to just share share some of my views with all of you here. And this question actually reminded me that what kind of really talk about source cooperation, you know, in these terms. And Dr. Hoffman just mentioned an African, you know, developed an African. So this also reminded me of the story. And around 2010, when I was working with the bank and in Tanzania, and so I had a meeting together with current minister for current minister of finance, Philip Mpango. And we were together with President Jiquetti. And Mr. President Jiquetti asked me to say, Professor Li, look, you know, and do you think our country is a developmental country? I said, no. And he asked me, why not? I think become developmental country, from my own understanding and experiences, is very difficult. And then he asked me, why difficulty? I said, because you know, for the practice and the conduct of the developing countries like China, like Malaysia, can be very controversial politically. And many things we did, were considered as against human rights, basically. And it's against any kind of things. You look after justice. And the World Bank won't support you, because this the World Bank expert will be actually criticized to say, look, you what you're doing, and all these USAID and DFID will actually stop money to the World Bank to say you're doing things against human rights. So it is impossible. It is impossible for many African countries to become so-called developmental country. We actually term from our experiences today. Because we know what, you know, what does people talk about. So these two stories remind me, which Dr. Hoffman actually mentioned, issue of development and developmental state on the issues, which I come back to my contribution to this workshop here, and what I call the new source cooperation, and the whole. The new source cooperation actually emerged from a previous tradition what I call traditional social cooperation, which was substantially based on political solidarity. In 1960, but actually the concept of social cooperation was created not in the Bangun conference, but before, much earlier, by India, which India was the very big advocate for the social cooperation. So, and the merge from a kind of a more more non-material based exchange, and I would say the traditional social cooperation was largely based on the non-material exchange, or what I call the lack of experiences, a lack of the material exchange, more from kind of a political solidarity and a mutual support, and that kind of relationship actually went beyond the ideological division. Ideological division was more or less like East and West relationship, and then South and North relationship was very largely referenced to the economic division for this. So that was the beginning. But for recent years, and a recent decade, and I found this interesting, a surprising new dimensions comes for what I called we could find in the future that the North in the South and the South in the North. So the structure of North and the South actually not only politically changed, and actually it will be in the future reshaped and reclassified. And because it's no longer the situation that you could easily see which country will be the North and the South. It's very complicated. So the relationship will be changed, all this structure. And the first striking story is the what I call the today, what I call the South. Traditionally, country grief souls already has a very special experiences, and compared to 1950s, 1960s, those days, unless you got political independence, and and I think again, Barak, you mentioned this kind of colonialization and post-colonialization. So largely, post-colonial regime from developing countries that took the legacy, complete legacy, political legacy, and also technical legacy from the colonial state. So there was no big difference, and even South Africa itself. And if you look South Africa is nothing to do with colonialization. It's the complete transfer of whole bureaucratic system from Europe. So this is very different, you know. You can't see anything from South Africa. So that is a situation where I look for the countries in 1950s, 60s, and there was unless you have these political struggles, and they're looking for Pan-Africanism, and they're looking for all kind of post-colonial knowledge things, and materially, and there was not much experiences for southern countries to share much, you know, unless you could learn from Mao Zedong and how you get independence from the imperialism, la 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 la, you know, very political, you know, and it is okay, it is fantastic, you know. And today it's very different, you know, you see the stories what I was talking about, this developmental state story, and it happens in China, and which is against the mainstream belief, against the mainstream mindset, against the mainstream of paradigm of development. And what does it mean democracy? And it's not driven by democracy. It's not driven by so-called democracy. It's not driven by it's not driven by the free election, you know, and this is driven by something else. So this is experiences exist for agriculture development, for many things. Now second one, and compared to a different from the previous times, you know, 1950s, 60s, there was no financial capacity, you know, and those countries poor, China were poor, you know, you don't have money to make any transfer or nothing else. But today we have, South country has financial capacity. So we can do a financial capacity as what you know the Michael just mentioned, and even you have smaller, but it is growing. And if you look for broad sense of development finance, it's huge money there. You know, it's not something, it's not insignificant. You know, it's hugely significant. That's very different. And lastly, and southern country realized it is not enough to have experiences. It's not enough to have what? To have money. we learned from you guys, we must have an institution. And we want to use institution. So that's why I'm not going to argue the bypass or substitution or anything. Why not? You know? Why not? You know, we need convergency, we need cooperation, we need all those things. Of course, that is different. That is anyway we need. We need collaboration with the World Bank and with IMF. No. We need. But we need a different identity, we need alternative. We need doing something which we really looks for this source cooperation in the future, different from North source cooperation. So these are things I would just conclude by saying that in the future, and the relationship between the North and the South will be reshaped, and even the will face the new type of challenge of the new type of donor and recipient relationship. You know, we have to be very careful. This is the challenge for us politically. We have to be careful. We cannot simply ignore coming. And the last word, I would say, the whole relationship of the global structure, power structure, will be reshaped. You know, in this. Thank you very much for my last words. Yeah.